Hello and welcome to this video review of Flixier. So Flixier is an online non-linear editor, so you can do editing on it. It's very similar to WeVideo, and at some point I'll be doing a comparison between WeVideo and Flixier, but today I'm just doing a review of Flixier. Here is the cost. It's $8 a month for most people. There's a free version and you get 2 gigabytes of storage and 10 minutes of exporting per month at 720. So you can always try this service out for free and see what you think of it before committing to purchasing. So you can see here, I land here and I've used Flixier to upload and create videos for my podcast. So I run a photography podcast. Let's just open one of these. And what I'm doing is I'm importing an audio track that is typically less than 20 megabytes, and I'm adding some text and some pictures. This is probably a good way to talk through the editor. So what we can do, we can import media here, and we can import from your current device, Google Drive, and other cloud providers. And we can also record the screen. So we can record on webcam and we can record the screen as well, which is quite useful. I don't think WeVideo has that included in the free version. We can also take stock footage, and we can take stock footage from Unsplash, Pixabay, or Pexels. So Unsplash does photos only. Pixabay has videos as well. And also Pexels has videos. So they're free, but then again, they're free anyway because they're free stock footage sites. I suppose it just saves you having to go looking for them. You can do it within the app and you can search within the app itself, which is handy. And you don't have to download it and then re-upload it. You can just copy it into your timeline. Audio, we've got some audio tracks here, backing tracks. I take the filter off. Seems to be stuck on summer, which is unfortunate. We've got some sort of overlays here, and these all look quite good. We've got some motion graphics. And particularly if you're making videos for social media, these sort of subscribe badges are very good and useful. We've got some text. We've got quite a lot of text styles here that we can do. We can add shapes, which is quite useful, and we've got transitions. Now, one of the things Flixier prides itself on is having this review process. So you can put an edit together and you can generate a review link and someone can go and look at the video as it is and then give you feedback, which is quite useful. What's really useful about online video editors is the speed you can turn things around. So you can do your editing and then you can give it to someone to review or give feedback, and you can make changes instantly and they can instantly see those changes wherever they are in the world, which is quite useful. So I'm going to start a new project. And this is going to just be called test. So we're going to go back here. I'm going to import something from my device. I'm going to import a new logo that I've got. So we pick it and we click import all. When I first started using Flixier for a trial, small files imported easily and without issue, but anything that was bigger than sort of 20 megabytes had a problem. So when I tried editing video, obviously with an online video editor, you need to upload video. When I tried that, I was never able to import big files. And I'm not talking gigabyte files, I'm talking megabyte files. I have fed back to the company and they say they've worked on a fix, but I haven't been able to verify that that works at the moment. While we're just having an upload, we'll have a look down here. Down here, we've got an intercom button and you can contact support really. So you can ask questions or you can start a conversation. You'll see here, I've had conversations about doing YouTube exports and about the import problem. So I'm going to get rid of that. That's quite useful to be able to give contact with people that quickly within the app. So you don't have to go and do an email. It's already done for you. So we've imported our media. I can bring it down here. And now we can scrub through it as we would normally. This is just a new logo. It's probably processing in the cloud. I can move it along. And we have certain effects that we can do. So we've got green screen. We can add shadow. Looks like we can provide effects. This one looks quite good. Let's add glitched. That's quite good. In terms of color, we can do very basic adjustments. So we can't adjust shadows. We can adjust brightness. I really quite like to adjust shadows and highlights for my footage, because generally when I film footage, I get the exposure okay, but it might be underexposed on shadows. And sometimes I'll shoot underexposed. I'll bring the shadows up in post, but I can't do that here. It's just very basic color editing. Audio, you can adjust the volume and take the audio off. So we can put the audio on a different track if we want. I'm just going to undo that so that we've got the audio there. So we've got basic effects. We can resize, crop. We can change the speed. We can go up to 5 times faster or 5 times slower. Let's put it back to 1. What's annoying is you can't select the text value. So you'll see I'm actually struggling to get it back to 1. Moving that, it's not precise enough moving that slider. So I'm going to add in some stock footage. This looks good. Let's add that in. And I'm going to add in a picture as well. So I'm going to go to Unsplash and I'm going to search for summer camp. Let's have a look. That seems to fit with the video. So I'm going to put a track down. I'm going to put an audio track down. We get a preview of what the effect looks like if we do that. I'm going to put some transitions in first. Let's go, let's bounce that. And let's stick one there. It's gone very big for some reason. I just want some small transitions, so I'm just going to adjust those. So let's just play through that. Not looking great, but so we can center that. I got a motion. Well, let's put a subscribe badge in here. That'll be quite useful. And that would go, we'd want that down the corner. That's very useful. It means you don't have to make it yourself. So add some text. I just want some simple text. Just want a title really that I can give the video, an overlay title. Summer at the beach, there we go. One of the things we're going to have at the end, how do I make this smaller? So one of the things we're going to do here is we would split this, get rid of that, and we'd just have a fade to black at the end. There we are, dip to black. That's... In terms of audio, I'm going to add a fade out. I'm going to add a fade in. So some things are really easy to do, which is nice. I can't make that any smaller. That's fine though. So if I wanted to do a voiceover, I'd have to go to media and I'd have to go to import and I'd have to do a voiceover like this. Yes, you can use my microphone. Hi, and welcome to summer at the beach. Excellent. Goodbye. Yep, we're gonna, that's good. That's gonna save, import all. Hello, and welcome to summer at the beach. So, yeah, you can see we're getting an import problem here, which isn't good. So I'm going to give up on doing a voiceover. We can add tracks. We can delete empty tracks. We can lock tracks. We can make them non-visible, which is really useful. We can go along. We can cut and we can add. We can do advanced editing. There are some things that obviously something like Final Cut Pro or a more traditional desktop editor is going to be better at, but pretty much what you'd want to do in a video editor, you can do here. So I'm going to save that because I'm going to go back to projects. So we can share the review. We can put an expiry on it, which is interesting, and we can make it public or private. So we can share and we can make it private so that only people who I put the email address into can view it, or we can generate a URL sharing link. Let's make that public. So we can go and copy that and we can go and send it to people and say, have a look at this video. Tell me what you think. Back into our editor. So because I'm using a free account, it's going to be watermarked made of Flixier. It's telling me I don't have enough export time because I'm on the free plan. So I get 10 minutes per month, and clearly I've used up my 10 minutes, but it doesn't tell me when that restriction ends. Is it tomorrow? Is it on the 30th of the month? I don't know. So we can export to YouTube, Vimeo, Google Drive, etc. And that's one of the benefits of using an online video editor. Once you've uploaded your media, you don't need to then download your video and re-upload it to YouTube or destination sites. It can just pass through in the cloud. I can pick my thumbnail, or I can upload a custom thumbnail, which is quite useful. What we can do, just scrub along and find your frame. Summer at the beach. That looks good. And unfortunately, I can't export it because I've run out of export time. I'm going to go to these templates because they've got templates already built, and templates are really for short video clips for social media. So let's have a look at this Black Friday one. So there are many, many web editors that do these short media clips for social media, little short clips. There aren't many online proper editors. I would consider this an online proper editor, but it's also useful that we've got this ability, if you take out a subscription or a free account, to do these short online social media videos as well. So of course these things are all fully editable, so let's find the text here. So I can go and change this to suit me, and I can go and change the pictures, and then someone has access to an easy Black Friday template. So we're going to go back to projects. It'll probably tell me it hasn't saved. That's interesting, it didn't create a new project for me. Flixier is good as a online video editor. I like the review aspect, but when I compare it to something like WeVideo, I find there are problems. One of the problems I've had is the upload problem. There have been issues uploading, and I've certainly experienced that. What I do like is the free stock footage that's included, and the fact that it just syncs seamlessly. When I pulled in the video, I didn't need to download the video, then re-upload the video. It's synced from the cloud, so I don't need to worry about that. That's a good time saver. We've got some music that I haven't heard, and we've got some quite good motion animations. Transitions and texts, I think, are okay. It's quite nice that you've got pre-made templates. That's quite useful. And you can see here, I've been able to export my footage. And of course, once you've made your video, you can also download it at any time. So the question is, would I get Flixier? I certainly will keep my free account for Flixier. Will I get a paid account? I don't know, because while it's good, if it was the only online video editor, then I think the answer would be yes. I'm not sure it's better than WeVideo. I don't think it beats WeVideo. It's a very similar price to WeVideo, and I feel you get much more on WeVideo. That's not to say this isn't a good online video editor. It has some improvements over WeVideo, like the integration with the free stock sites. The review aspect is quite good, although you can still do that on WeVideo, and the templates are quite nice. But for me, I think I'll be sticking with WeVideo, and I'll go more into that in my future video comparing the two. I hope you found this useful, and I hope you found it informative, and it's given you some idea of what you can do with Flixier, and if it's for you. Thank you. Goodbye.